Welcome to MarcusG.TV. I'm Chef Marcus Giuliano, and I'm a chef on a mission. Today's mission
is
relationships. We did our first relationship video last week.
Yes.
With huge success.
Yes. I guess people really liked it.
And then
they like to see me on video.
They like to see you on video. They even on LinkedIn, I got a comment on relationships. Thank you for this. It was the topic of jealousy. And how jealousy can really be detrimental to your health, to a relationship, and just how it's not good to be jealous. And
right.
Jealousy really, it breaks the relationship down, and it becomes, you know, love is freedom. Love isn't owning somebody, and love isn't, you know, I'm not allowing somebody to do something. Within reason, of course, because I wouldn't let you hurt yourself.
Right.
So then we got a comment, and we answered the comment, and he just commented back on our YouTube channel. Thank you for clarifying it, and he's happy to see you.
Oh, why I wasn't on camera.
Right. Must say something about a relationship, and we clarified that, but you're back on camera, and I want to get you on camera as much as possible.
I don't really enjoy being on camera. But I'm doing it because the fans out there are looking for it, I guess.
I think it's going to improve our ratings.
I guess. Yeah, I think so.
And our producer of Aroma Time Radio really loved our Thanksgiving stuff that we were interacting with,
yes.
Going back and forth. He was really said that you're a natural and that it really added a great element to the show.
Okay.
So our stuff that we do on our YouTube also ends up on Aroma Time Radio, and it also ends up on Chef on a Mission Radio. Aroma Time Radio being once a month, Chef on a Mission Radio being weekly. You can go to chefonamission.com and get those links for those and listen to those on demand. And of course, you can also catch our YouTube channel. So it's kind of, some of the stuff is rehashed in and out, and we sometimes share content so it gets broader audience.
Yes.
So relationships today. Let's talk about, what do you want to talk about in relationships?
I think that we should talk about compliments.
Okay.
And how not only do we compliment each other, but how we compliment each other in our relationship, right?
Okay.
So
there's two kinds of compliments. Me saying, you look great today, or us working well together.
I'm talking about the one where we compliment each other and say nice things
about.
Yes.
I am constantly telling you how beautiful you look.
Yes.
I think I've done that for years.
Yes. It took me a while to notice it. But yes, you do that quite a bit.
Well, I don't think for a while you believed it. Did you?
Well, no, I think that a lot of a relationship has to do with your self-esteem.
Absolutely.
And how well you feel about yourself in order to be able to accept those compliments from other people.
Because I was telling you were beautiful when you were 40 pounds heavier.
Yes.
Without the toned muscle that you have now.
Right.
I mean, I was telling you that you were beautiful. I never minded your stomach, you know, after you had babies,
right.
We had our kids. I never minded that post-baby stomach that a lot of women say they can't get rid of, that you've successfully worked your butt off and worked very hard in the gym.
Yes.
I always tell you how proud I am of you.
Yes. I think that's a big one. I think we're both proud of each other. You know, I tell you all the time that we couldn't work without each other, we couldn't be without each other, we wouldn't have what we have without each other, and that we are proud of each other, which is very important.
I'm very proud of you, and I'm proud that you are my business partner. I'm very proud that you're the mother to our kids. I'm very proud that you're my wife. I'm very proud that you're my partner, and I tell you that as much as I possibly can. It's funny though, because when I stop telling you for like 2 days,
I get upset.
You get upset, yeah. You say to me like, you haven't told me, and you don't appreciate me, and this and that, and I'm like, really?
Well, it's not that I think that you don't appreciate me, it's just that it's nice to hear it when you're used to hearing it all the time,
right?
So it can kind of go the other way as well, where you're used to hearing things all the time, and then you don't hear them, you're wondering why you're not hearing them anymore.
Right.
Well, what happened? Did I lose that, you know, that respect of that compliment? Did I gain weight? Do I not look good? Do I, you know, not please you? Are you not happy with...
Did I find somebody? Am I giving those compliments to somebody else?
Maybe. I don't know.
You know?
No. But I think it's important, those compliments in a relationship are very important. And I give compliments in ways, you know, when I'm talking about you, I always tell people how proud I am
of you. You do, you always talk me up to other people.
I always talk you up to other people. You know, and I am very proud of what you do and your success and what we've done with our business and our family and all of the things that we do have, you know, in our lives. You know, I find compliments in other ways as well. You know, I feel that I, you know, take care of lots of things around the house and I'm always doing all of those things. And I think that that's a compliment that you don't have to do them and that I take care of that stuff for you, you know, and right. I'm always willing to jump in and do anything for you anytime you ask. I've become a little bit stricter lately where I'm making you do things a little bit more, but I think that we, you know, complement each other well in that aspect.
Yeah, I mean, I love coming home in the houses when you've, like, cleaned the bathroom or something.
Right.
I just love it, and I just say, thanks for cleaning. It looks great.
Yes.
Because I honestly appreciate everything that you do.
And what did I say to you this morning? I said, oh, did you get rid of that branch that's been scraping up against my car?
And I said, yes, I did.
Yes, you did.
But it must have popped back out.
So, it didn't pop back out. No. But you know, I said, oh, thank you for, you know, taking care of that as well. So it's very important in relationships to compliment your spouse or your partner.
And to praise.
And to praise them. And, you know, I think the same thing goes with our kids as well, you know.
I praise the kids all the time. I tell them how proud I am of them.
And we are very proud of them. They're good kids and we're good people. And so, you know, you want to raise
and
them.
And I always tell them how lucky they are to have a mother like you.
Yes.
I always tell them how lucky they are and, you know, and how fortunate that I am, too, that we have you. The one thing that I'm really fortunate of, and I compliment you on, is working in the office here with you, working together, running the business with you, because a lot of couples don't have that.
No.
They don't have that where they go to work and they go their separate ways. And
well, they don't know what's going on all day, and they have no idea how the other person is feeling and reacting and... You know, when they come home from work, how tired they are. And I think, you know, we've always heard the big complaint when the man walks through the door and the woman just wants to hand the kids, you know, to them because they're tired, you know, from working all day. I mean, now in today's society, in today's world, most parents, you know, both parents have jobs.
Work.
But, you know, that old saying of, here, take the kids, I've had it, you know, we have to look and think, like, what happened in their day, you know, in your day.
In both people's days.
And I think it's important for couples to communicate with each other. I think it's a little bit easier now with text messaging and the phones and, you know, you have consistent, contact.
You compliment me all the time via text message.
Yes.
I always get I love yous. I always get kisses. I always get, you know, I always get a lot of things. So I think that, I know that most couples just don't appreciate the small things.
No, it's important to appreciate the small things in a relationship. You know, it's very hard to forget them. It's easy to overlook them. It's easy to not think about them. But you have to, especially to make a relationship successful and make it work and be proud of your relationship and what you have, because people just walk away so easily, you know, from relationships.
Right. I love when you're in the office here and you're sitting at your desk right across from me.
Yes.
And I walk over and I just grab your shoulders and I start kissing your
neck. Yeah, you did that this morning.
I love doing that to you.
Yes.
I love just walking over there. And usually you come in your gym clothes.
Yes.
In your, you know, in your gym clothes. And I love you in your gym clothes. And
yeah,
I'm
in that today, unfortunately. I don't like to do videos like this, but I did it today for you.
And, you know, you just walk in and you're just the most gorgeous thing ever to me.
Thank you.
You've been like that for years. Like I said, no matter what, how much you weighed, no matter if you just had the kids, you know, I've always loved you for, and paid compliments to you because I love you.
Right.
And not because it's what you look like, not because it's what you look like during that part of the day or whatever. Of course, I love when you're dressed up and you look great and you know, and you're all... You know, you have your makeup and you have whatever on and you're ready to go out. I mean, of course, you're just drop dead gorgeous. But I always compliment you on, I just love complimenting you. I love you is the bottom line.
Right.
And
compliments are important to hear.
And I love just being able to say to you, and I know when you compliment me, it makes my day.
Right.
It just totally makes my day.
And just out of the blue, I'll send you a message, right?
Right, right, you will. You will. This morning, we had a phone call really early this morning, like at 5:30, the phone rang.
Yeah, 6 o'clock, yeah.
Before our business phones to our cell phones. And I knew who it was our one distributor calling saying they were out of something. And you know what she said to me? She was, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realize that I was going to get a real person answering. I thought I was going to get, you know,
right,
a voice. And I answered, and I was totally fine, because I was awake.
We were awake.
And she goes, you have a great voice. I was like, that's a great compliment.
That is a good compliment.
You know, but it's the small things that you know, you don't think of in your spouse, in your relationship, in your boyfriend, girlfriend, significant other. The smallest things make the biggest difference.
They do.
And I think those daily compliments that have to be true and genuine.
Well, you have to really feel them.
You have to really feel it.
You can't just say it without the feeling
behind
it.
Without the feelings.
And a lot of people can tell whether there's feeling. Like, I know when you're just saying something, you know, to say something. But most times you're not, you know. But there are times where we say something just to say it, you know, because we think we have to say it. But put that meaning behind it and make sure that you really feel it.
So how would a couple in a relationship start to change this? Let's say there's no compliments going on. Let's say if the wife says, well, he never compliments me. What would you recommend that wife do?
Start complimenting him.
Perfect. Start
I
making
think
the
compliments. You need to start, you know, we can go around and around and around and it becomes a pattern, right? We don't do this, we don't do that, we don't do this, we don't do that. So it becomes a circle, and the circle just goes around and around, and you have to break that cycle. And you might have to be the one who starts
it.
If you want to be getting those compliments, then maybe you should look back and say, hey, I'm not even giving those compliments.
Maybe
I should start giving compliments to people, to my spouse or my, you know, significant other.
I think most marriages, most relationships spend most of their time in reaction. In reaction mode. You did that. Why'd you do that? You know, are you an idiot for doing that? I can't believe you forgot that.
Right.
As opposed to, thanks for doing that, honey. I love you. Thanks,
right.
You know, you look great after going to the gym, you know, or I love when you go to the gym because you come back energized. And I love when you eat healthy because it helps me eat healthy.
Right.
You know, I love sitting down and sharing a glass of wine with you, sharing a bottle of wine. I love doing things. I look forward to doing that. I you know, it just totally changes the whole mood of a relationship. And I think you have to be the change that you want to see.
Right.
Is the bottom line.
You have to be what you want is what you need to,
yep,
to do. You know, we teach our kids, you know,
to practice
what you preach, right?
Do unto others as you do unto yourself.
So,
right. So that's an important thing, is you have to be able to compliment yourself. And I think years ago in our relationship, you didn't know how to compliment yourself. You didn't know, you didn't have self-confidence. Of course, guys are more self-confident than women because women are just so judgmental.
Well, our society makes us very judgmental.
They make you girls crazy. They totally make you girls crazy. And you get on Facebook, you get on these magazines,
you see
billboards.
A specific way, a set way to become successful and to, you know, to be a model and to be in magazines.
To have the sex appeal
that the guys are looking for. And women out there, you need to feel good about yourselves, and you need to look in that mirror and tell yourself that you're beautiful every day. And I started doing that years ago, and it feels good to look in the mirror and say, wow, I really am pretty, you know? Yeah, I might not like this or I might not like that, but you know what? Guys are not looking at that. And that took me a long time to realize that guys are really not looking at the things that we're looking at.
They're not.
They're looking a little past that. So take those compliments and enjoy them, and you know, and give them back, because they make a big difference in, you know, in a relationship.
Now, if you dressed like a slob all day, and didn't take a shower, and I came home and you had pajamas on, or you came here to work and soon after you had your pajamas on and your hair up, it's kind of harder to give you compliments.
Well, of course.
So you can't neglect yourself, and you know, so that's the thing. You've got to give your spouse a reason to compliment.
Of course.
On top of them genuinely wanting to comment or give you a compliment.
Of course, yes.
So there's a lot of different ways, but you know, start giving compliments. Get your self-esteem up, which is just, it's up to you to do that. It's how you feel about yourself. Love yourself and love your spouse, and just keep the compliments flowing, and you will see a drastic improvement in your relationship.
I think so. There's a lot of things, you know, that you can improve upon.
So, but yeah, stop living in reaction.
Yes.
Stop living in reaction mode. You know, even I'll break up your reactions sometimes, and I have reactions too. We both fight. We both fight. So let's not think on camera here that we're the most perfect couple.
No, we're definitely
because
not.
We're not. We argue, you know, and we don't agree, and we have to do a lot of compromising. Sometimes it compromises in the way I want to do it, and you know, and just, I need
never,
my moment.
He never wants to do it.
I just need my moments away from you, just so I can breathe and relax and regroup myself
but
and
we've
come back.
We've learned how to, you know, to deal with that, and I think that's what we want to go into in our next section.
Is how to react properly and stop the reaction, because you're going to react when things don't go your way. You're going to react, but why should you keep the reaction going?
Yes.
You know, so I did that, or I didn't do that, or I forgot to do this. How much longer can you harp on me not doing that? Maybe we'll tell the story about the toilet paper.
Okay.
Not now.
Okay.
Next episode.
That's a surprise.
We'll give that a surprise. The famous toilet paper episode that changed a significant action that I do for the last 12 years.
Yeah.
12 years ago. Yeah, that was very, made a big impact on me.
Yeah, I hear it all
toilet,
the time.
The toilet paper episode. We'll talk about that in our next relationship video.
Sounds good.
I'm Chef Marcus Giuliano.
And Jamie.
Thanks for watching. Definitely like our videos.
Subscribe.
Leave comments. And leave questions so we know what topics to cover next.
And pass it on.
Definitely pass it on. Absolutely. Thanks for watching.